Tonight, a mega indictment
for a monster sexual predator.
I'm Chris Flanagan.
And I'm Danita Harris.
A grand jury indicted Elias Acevedo on 293 charges.
Those charges announced hours ago, murder, kidnapping, and rape.
In moments, key details inside the indictment, information that blew the lid off two cold cases that were decades old.
We have reaction from those closest to the case and the warnings those relatives gave investigators about Acevedo.
And more than that, an in-depth look at the key evidence that reopened these cold cases and the evidence that led the police and FBI to Acevedo. News Channel 5 at 11 starts right now.
On your side, with Northeast Ohio's best coverage, this is News Channel 5.
Today, 49-year-old Elias Acevedo was charged with the murder of Pamela Pemberton and another woman authorities believe is Christina Atkins, missing since 1995.
And this result should send a message to other sex offenders that you can run, but you can hide, and a promise kept to the survivors and the families that we will never forget, nor will we ever give up.
Acevedo faces 293 total counts, including aggravated murder. He's also charged with rape and kidnapping of two girls when they were as young as 8 and 11. And back in June, he was charged in a 1993 rape case. Of the 293 counts, 173 of those are for rape and 115 are for kidnapping. Cuyahoga County Prosecutor Tim McGinty said that authorities uncovered Acevedo as a person of interest while revisiting cold cases after Ariel Castro's arrest.
Well, U.S. Marshals arrested Acevedo in connection with the 1993 rape. Further investigation has now linked him to these other cases. The head of Cleveland's FBI office credits the public with helping crack them.
If it wasn't for the community's cooperation and the willingness to step forward and provide some critical information, we wouldn't be here. And as we've said for the last several months, if that's one positive that could come out of the kidnapping of our three Cleveland girls, this is it.
Acevedo has a long criminal history that dates back to 1988. Court records revealed he has been treated for a mental disorder.
Violence against women was on the top of the agenda at the second Woman to Woman Forum on Cleveland's East Side. The forum was filled with judges, lawyers, and leaders discussing solutions to the problem. News Channel 5's Michael Baldwin was there. He joins us live now with more. Michael?
Yeah, Danita, the discussion mainly focused on women who might be in an abusive relationship, but in light of the big news story of the day, we got reaction to the indictment of Elias Acevedo. Over at the Harvard Community Center, a panel of judges and domestic violence survivors talked to a packed house about one subject, the safety of women.
Domestic violence, violence against women, is a issue that we don't necessarily talk about in full context.
Today, law enforcement made a huge announcement. Elias Acevedo is facing a 293-count indictment for murder and rape. Prosecutors say he killed Pamela Pemberton in 1994 and believe he is responsible for the murder of Christina Atkins in 1995. Judge Pinky Carr says today was a good day for the victims' families.
You know, I think it takes us back to the situation with Castro, with Gina, Amanda, and Michelle. I mean, once again, this community, it's a relief.
Domestic violence counselor Ilinda Reese says she knows what the victims' families are feeling.
They're finally getting some justice in what happened to their relative. However, it's bringing back all of those feelings that they were having while it was also going on.
The coalition wants women to remember a few basic things. If you're walking, make eye contact when you pass people in case you need to recall the information later. When you enter a building, make sure you know your exits. Always travel in a group. And if you got that funny feeling about your safety, take precautions. The coalition wanted people to know there is help for all victims.
There are services now for victims' families, and I think that's one thing that we have now that we did not have in the past.
All right, the forum made several lawyers available for free consultation who were especially dealing with women's issues. We're live on your side. I'm Michael Baldwin, News Channel 5.
And tonight, relatives close to the investigation say they are horrified after today's breaking news shed light on the crimes. News Channel 5's Stephanie Ramirez live tonight with those details.
And Chris, I spoke with Christina Atkins' sister. Their family is hoping to get more concrete information from the FBI. But tonight, I also spoke with the family of Christina Atkins' boyfriend, who told us in the past of how they are related to Acevedo. They watched today's news conference together.
It's unbelievable to hear all the counts and all the people that he's been hurt. all the family that is ruined, you know, with all this crime that he's done. And it's just unbelievable.
Sonia Baez's response to the 293-count indictment of the person they called a distant cousin, 49-year-old Elias Acevedo.
It was very compelling evidence.
While the indictment against him includes charges for the aggravated murder of a Jane Doe, authorities believe Acevedo is connected to the disappearance of Christina Atkins, who was about 5 months pregnant around the time she was last seen, and dating Baez's brother, Jose Rivera.
Ryan Hill on disgrace. I don't call him my family.
Rivera's words to Acevedo, the family telling us of how upset they are with the crime that's been going on in their West Side neighborhood and the horrors a blood relative committed. Baez says not too long ago, she went to the FBI to warn them of Acevedo.
To look into him, that he most likely had something to do with it, and it came out to be true.
Next, police must identify the remains recently found. But Rivera's sister says,
I do believe in my heart and soul that it's her. I'm sorry for the family. It makes me sad because I loved Chrissy. She was a good girl. It makes me sad, but it also makes me sad because that could have been my niece or my nephew.
Yes.
So, you know, I hope that finally this all comes to a conclusion and we can move on.
And as we reported in the past, Rivera says he was blamed for Christina Atkins' disappearance for the past 18 years. Now he and his family say they're hoping to resolve their differences and come together with the Atkins family, especially to support one another during this time. Live in the newsroom on your side, Stephanie Ramirez, News Channel 5.
Another new development out of today's massive indictment. The cold cases of Ashley Summers and Amy Mihaljevic remain active. Summers disappeared in July of 2007 around the area of West 96th Street in Madison. The Mihaljevic case received national attention when the Bay Village girl went missing back in 1989. Her body eventually found in Ashland County.
So here is where the case stands now. Acevedo is scheduled to appear in court in December, and we are still waiting for the positive identification of remains found last week that police believe could be Christina Atkins. You can read more about today's developments on our website, newsnet5.com. Now, coming up in 10 minutes, our team coverage continues. We'll explore the process of reopening Cleveland's cold cases and getting rape kits tested that have sat for many years.